Night, great night of boxing here in Los Angeles. I'm really pleased. First, when we started the day off with the CBS show, it was a tremendous. Close the door there. So we started the day off, with the CBS, the return of boxing to CBS. Leo Santa Cruz, a tremendous performance. He did what he had to do, threw a lot of punches by any measure. Maybe if you measure it against his own, then it wasn't as many as he usually throws. But I'm not really surprised about it. He fought five times this year. That means over 10 months training camp. So Leo will take a couple months off now and probably be back sometime in April. CBS was very pleased with the telecast. It looked fantastic. I watched the telecast as well. Great, and I think we're going to have fantastic ratings. Boxing is back on terrestrial TV here in the United States with CBS. As a matter of fact, CBS and Leo Santa Cruz were trending worldwide during the telecast on Twitter, so that's a very, very good sign. So I'm looking to get at least four additional dates, maybe one a quarter, or maybe more often on CBS. I think the key is to use those big CBS sports events as a lead-in to showcase this great sport of boxing. Then here with the live show, we had a great fight on Extreme with Sean Porter and Julio Diaz, a tremendous toe-to-toe battle. I mean, it doesn't get much better than that. Great night from the Olympians as well. Jojo Diaz had a great, a fantastic first fight, looked very good, shows you why we are so excited. I think he has a terrific pro style, and I think he will go very far. As for the other, all the other Olympians which were on the card. Then with the televised portion of the Showtime event, when we started with Alfredo Angulo against Jorge Silva, I mean, what two warriors they are. I mean, that Jorge Silva must have like a brick chin or whatever, you know, I mean, it's unbelievable. There was our steel chin, nothing could shatter it, and we all know that Alfredo Angulo hits very, very hard, but this guy just wouldn't go. A great performance, and I think Alfredo needed that in his comeback. I don't think it does him good if he knocks everybody out within less than a minute of the first round. So a great performance of Alfredo Angulo. I think we are very excited now, two fights in a short period of time. He's back, and we're going to go in 2013 for bigger and better things with Alfredo Angulo. So please, Alfredo, if you want to say a few words, or if you guys have any questions. Any questions?
Okay.
Alfredo, any comments?
Alfredo, you didn't get hit much in your first fight back. In this fight, you got hit quite a bit more. How did it feel to get hit by a quality guy with he had a lot of pop on his punches?
Eric, is there Eric or Roberto here, so they can translate? Thank you, Lucy.
Sorry, can you repeat the question, please?
Your first fight back, you didn't get hit by very much. Tonight, you went 10 rounds with a guy that hit you quite a bit. How did it feel to get hit by a guy that seemed to have a lot of snap on his punches?
Me siento muy contento de haber regresado y haber caminado en el round. Porque después de dos años creo que hicimos un excelente trabajo. Lo importante era caminar y ver en qué nivel estábamos, sinceramente.
I'm very happy with the work. That's the major point. I worked 10 rounds and my performance I feel was very good, and that's what I've been training for.
Pero, who would you want next?
This decision is the golden boy, no more. Mine is war in the gym.
Richard, who would you want next for him?
Well, we'll sit down with his management team and decide what's going to be next and when. But I know I speak for all fight fans. We can't wait to have Alfredo back in the ring.
Thank you.
Champ, this fighter seems to be tougher than what you anticipated.
Uh, I know I speak before, a lot of interviews, he's a real Mexican, you know, the real puncher, and the war in the ring, Mexican versus Mexican, is it tough?
Alfredo, en el primer round salió bien agresivo y te conectó con una derecha que te tamaleó un poco. ¿Qué fue tu reacción al inicio de la pelea?
Sinceramente me sorprendió porque que fuera así hacia el frente. Yo sé que en la entrevista se le había dicho que el perro lo habían hecho, que el perro era un peleador que no pegaba. Yo creo que después de esta noche el Pantera no opina lo mismo.